In this video, we'll go through the concepts of position error correction for the data reduction process of the tar flyby method. Let's dive in.
3, 2, 1, top.
3, 2, 1, half. The Flight Test Engineering Channel.
This is a prequel to the tar flyby data reduction video and covers the basic concepts for the method. We're not going to do actual coding here, and if you're looking for that content, click on this link, which will take you there.
On the tar flyby setup that I'm showing here, we have the camera placed at a known height above the runway, taking pictures of the aircraft as it flies along the runway and against a background, which includes a monument of known height. And what is the idea of PEC? Well, it is to correct for static pressure errors. So we need to compare the aircraft's static port to the true ambient pressure that is on the field unaffected by the aircraft.
And in this method, as the aircraft flies by,
we take pictures and also we take measurements of pressure and temperature at the camera point. And I'm showing here a yellow line to represent the level that we're taking these measurements. And then we can transfer from the camera height to the actual aircraft height. We will infer the aircraft's height from the pictures we're taking against the monument, which again, we know how tall it is. And once we have this estimate for the ambient pressure, we can compare to the aircraft's static port value and calculate the error. Let's look at the geometry that we will be using in this exercise.
So we're going to be using simulation here to fly our test points, which is good because it allows you to fly them at home as well if you want to reproduce what I'm doing. We're going to place our camera right at the control tower here of the Innsbruck airport, and right across the runway there's going to be a weather radar tower against which we're going to measure how high the aircraft is flying above the runway. Of course, if you go to the actual aircraft, actual airport in Innsbruck, you're not going to find this tower there because these are the glider's strips. And of course, they would not place a tower that high over there. Let's play the video here and have a look from the ground level. So as we go down, you see that, here's the airport terminal from Innsbruck. Our control tower is over here. Right, a few cars in the parking lot, and over across the runway, here is the tower that I'm talking about. This is a weather radar tower that was placed here. We know the height, which is 75 meters, and that's what will serve as our background for our tar flyby method. Okay, so we're going to place our camera here at the control tower, which will be looking outside the window to see the airplane flying over the runway center line. And don't worry, we'll be able to estimate how much off center line we are flying for each test point. This will form a plane here. And on the background, you have the weather radar tower for which we know the height, which is 75 meters. And we'll be able to estimate whatever aircraft delta H we have from the picture we take. We'll use geometry here to estimate this value by calculating the tangent for angle alpha. Tangent is defined as the opposite over adjacent legs. So using the big triangle, we're going to have delta aircraft photo that we measure from our photo plus tower height minus our camera reference height forming the opposite leg. And the adjacent leg is going to be the camera to tower distance, which in this case is going to be 520 meters. The same angle is going to have the tangent calculated through the small triangle, which is going to be our aircraft delta H minus our camera reference height, forming this small leg here, divided by whatever distance we have from the camera to the runway. Then we can equate the calculation for the two tangents, which is up here, and we can isolate aircraft delta H to obtain this value that we want. Let's do a quick recap here of what we're measuring. We're measuring ambient pressure and temperature at the camera level, and then through this aircraft delta H, we'll be able to transport whatever pressure, static pressure we have here, to around the aircraft, and we'll be able to compare with whatever we measure from the ship. Let's look at a test point execution to see how this works. Okay, so let's look at the first test point here. Target airspeed is going to be 130 knots. This again is playing on in FlightGear out of Innsbruck. We are sort of aligned on the runway here. We have our control tower on the right and our monument, the weather radar tower, here on the left. The view, this is a belly camera view from the aircraft. The view on the right hand side is the view from the tower looking at the aircraft, and that's where we're going to take our pictures from for the data reduction, as I just explained in the diagram. So your target's going to be 130 knots, but you don't have to be exactly at 130, 131, 32, doesn't matter, because we're going to build a curve anyway, so you don't have to be control exactly what the airspeed speed is. Your height also, you don't need to control a lot, because that's going to be measured from your picture. What you do need to control is your runway center line, because that changes the geometry, as we saw. And as we come by here, you can see the tower appearing in your field of view here on the left. Your control tower already went by, and on the right, top right-hand corner, you can see the aircraft going by. I'm sorry for the low frame rate here, but the computer is not so powerful. But you can see the tower right there, and that's the aircraft, and that's where we're going to snap our picture to measure what is the actual aircraft height from this test point. To measure the delta aircraft photo quantity from our diagram, I have the snapshot from one of the test points open here in GIMP, which is a free open source software for image manipulation. So let's zoom in a little bit here and see what we can figure out. We have the weather radar tower here and the aircraft passing, but we can zoom in a little bit more and increase our precision while measuring the pixels. Even more, we can zoom in at, let's say, maximum here. And we can recenter the image. All right, so good. Now let's pick up the measuring tool here. And we can measure in pixels what is the amount from the tip of my tower to the bottom, which we know it's 75 meters. And here we can read 84 pixels, okay? So now we can adjust the scale by going to print size and saying that when I measure pixels per meter, we're going to have here 84 pixels per 75 meters. Okay. So now we can go back down here and measure it directly in meters. And we can measure from the tip of my aircraft on the vertical to the tip of my tower, which is going to equate to 79.4 meters. While we have done this for one test point, you're going to have to do this for every TP that you fly. And one last concept that I want to touch base with you is the fact that we are assuming that when we measure airspeed on a pitot tube, we are converting all of the kinetic energy into static pressure with no loss, and this will be important later when we calculate the speed error. I hope this content was useful for you, and this link will take you to the main data reduction video. See you there!